Nasogastric tubes are widely used for gastric aspiration or decompression and for administration of medications or nutrition. However, inability to identify malpositioned tubes and their complications remains a major issue. Malpositioned tubes can be associated with the potential for harm, and prolonged hospital stay or inpatient death can occur as a result. This video will go through the process for confirmation of normal nasogastric tube position on chest X-ray. Let us firstly recap the normal path of a nasogastric tube and its related anatomy. A nasogastric tube normally passes from the nasal cavity to the stomach. The structures it passes through in its path are the nasal cavity, nasopharynx, oropharynx, hypopharynx, esophagus, and stomach. A chest X-ray images the nasogastric tube as it passes vertically down the esophagus into the stomach. As the esophagus is not visible on a chest X-ray, it is essential to have an understanding of the normal anatomical position of the esophagus in relation to other visible structures to allow us to know where the nasogastric tube has been placed. Typically, the esophagus passes vertically over and slightly to the left of the trachea. The esophagus is then positioned adjacent and immediately to the right of the aortic knuckle. The esophagus then passes vertically down in the midline below the diaphragm and past the gastroesophageal junction into the stomach. Here is a step-by-step guide to confirmation of a normal nasogastric tube position. Firstly, determine whether the chest X-ray covers the adequate region of interest from the upper esophagus to below the diaphragm. The tube should be clearly visible throughout its length, including to its tip. In some cases, you may have to manually adjust the window setting to increase the conspicuity of the tube. Alternatively, look for a companion line enhancement image. These are images performed with a specific image processing algorithm that highlights tube and line features. The image is processed by the radiographer and may be available in some cases. We follow the path of a nasogastric tube in upper thorax and confirm the tube passes vertically in the midline, over or slightly to the left of the trachea, and then adjacent immediately to the right of the aortic knuckle. The carina should be identified as a termination of the trachea as it bifurcates into the right and left main bronchus at approximately the level of T4 or T5. The nasogastric tube should be seen to bisect the carina. The right and the left main bronchus should be able to be separately identified. The tube must not follow the course of the right or left main bronchus. The nasogastric tube should be then seen to follow the path of the lower esophagus and then pass below the level of the left hemidiaphragm. The tip of the nasogastric tube should be clearly seen beyond the level of the gastroesophageal junction for it to be within the stomach. Look specifically for nasogastric tube malpositioning and complications. The nasogastric tube is commonly too short, in which this could be due to the distal end looping upwards and returning to the hypopharynx or the upper third of the esophagus. The tip of the tube could also simply be too proximal, within the distal esophagus or even below the diaphragm but around the gastroesophageal junction too proximally in the stomach. Note that if the tube contains side holes, all of the side holes and not just the tip must be distal to the gastroesophageal junction to decrease aspiration risk. The tube should not enter the main bronchi or the lungs to avoid airway or pulmonary injury. Inadvertent placement and advancement of the tube even more distally can extend the tube to the pleural space. Intracranial placement is a serious inadvertent placement. This is more likely if the patient has craniofacial fractures or history of sinus surgery. However, in patients without these risk factors, intracranial placement has also been reported. In these cases, the rigidity of the tube may cause it to fracture bony barriers and pass intracranially. Complications of nasogastric tube insertion include pneumothorax, aspiration pneumonia, or lung injury. Pharyngeal or esophageal injury can also occur, which uncommonly is in the form of esophageal hematoma or esophageal perforation.